Now, we need to subtract using column subtraction, but this time, we'll need to exchange across zeros, so exchange across more than one place value. First, we have 5006 minus 55, so we set the question out in the usual way, with the digits lined up on the right-hand side. 6 minus 5 is 1, but then, onto our tens, we have 0 minus 5. 5 is larger than 0, so we need to exchange. But when we go to the left, this time we have another 0. So we go to the left again, 1 less, 1 in front, and then the same thing, so 1 less than 10 is 9, and 1 in front. So what we've done here is first exchanged one of our thousands for 10 hundreds, and then taken one of those hundreds and exchanged it for 10 tens. So now 10 minus 5 is 5, 9 minus nothing is 9, 4 minus nothing is 4. So our answer is 4,951. Now 4,002 minus 533. Starting on the right, we have 2 minus 3. But 3 is larger than 2, so we need to exchange. We go to the left, but we have a 0. So we go to the left again, but we have another 0. So we need to go to the left again. So we keep moving to the left until we reach a digit that's not 0. Then 1 less, 1 in front. 1 less than 10 is 9, 1 in front. And then again, 1 less, 1 in front. So now that we have a 1 in front of our 2, we have 12 minus 3, which is 9. 9 minus 3 is 6, 9 minus 5 is 4, and 3 minus nothing is 3. So that gives us 3,469. 7,008 minus 3,933. 8 minus 3 is 5. We can't do 0 minus 3 using the column method. We go to the left, we have a 0. So we go to the left again, 1 less, 1 in front, 1 less, 1 in front. So now 10 minus 3 is 7, 9 minus 9 is 0, 6 minus 3 is 3. So that gives us 3,075. Finally, let's work out 4,000 minus 2,436. We can't do 0 minus 6 using the column method. Go to the left, go to the left again, go to the left a third time, then 1 less, 1 in front, 1 less, 1 in front, 1 less, 1 in front. So now we have 10 minus 6, which is 4, 9 minus 3 is 6, 9 minus 4 is 5, and 3 minus 2 is 1. So our answer is 1,564. So now let's take a closer look at these questions and see why the method works. So why we keep going to the left, 1 less, 1 in front, and then we can keep on doing that until we've got 1 in front of the digit that we need, or the place value column that we're on. So for this first question, we started with 5,006, so that's 5,000s and 6 ones. We needed to subtract 55. First, we could take away 5 ones to leave us with 1 1 in our answer. But then, we needed to take away 5 tens, and we don't have any tens, and we don't have any hundreds to exchange with either. So that's why we go all the way across to our thousands, because we can take one of these thousands and exchange it for 10 hundreds. So now you can see because we've exchanged, we've only got 4 thousands and we've got 10 hundreds. But we need to subtract tens, so we can take one of our hundreds and exchange it for 10 tens. So now you can see because we exchanged again, rather than 10 hundreds, we've now only got 9 hundreds, but that's given us a 1 to put in front of our tens digit, so that gives us 10 tens. So now we can subtract 5 of those tens to leave us with 5 tens in our answer, and because we had to exchange, we've now got 9 hundreds and 4 thousands. Or using place value counters, we can start with 5,000 and 6. First, we can subtract 5 ones to give us 1 as the ones digit of our answer. But then we need to subtract 5 tens, so we need to get some tens counters. The way to do that is to first exchange one of our thousand counters for 10 hundreds, and then we can take one of those hundreds and exchange it for 10 tens. So now we can subtract 5 of those tens, and that leaves us with 5 as the tens digit of our answer, and because we exchanged, we now have 9 hundreds and 4 thousands. Our next question was 4,002, so that's 4 thousands and 2 ones, and we needed to subtract 533. So to subtract 3 ones, we can subtract the 2 ones that we start with, but we need to subtract 3 ones, so we need to subtract 1 more 1. So first, we can exchange one of our thousands for 10 hundreds, so that's why we have 3 up here and 1 in front of our hundreds digit. Then we can take one of those hundreds and exchange it for 10 tens, so now we only have 9 hundreds, but we have 10 tens. And finally, we can take one of those tens and exchange it for 10 ones, so that's why we have 9 as our tens digit now. So remember, we've already subtracted 2 ones, so if we subtract 1 more, we get 9 as the ones digit of our answer. Now we can subtract 3 of our tens to leave us with 6 tens, and 5 of our hundreds to leave us with 4 hundreds. We're not subtracting any thousands, so we still have 3 as our thousands digit of our answer. Or using place value counters, we start with 4,002. First, we need to subtract 3 ones. We can subtract 1, 2, exchange, exchange again, and exchange again. So now we can subtract our third one to give us 9 as the ones digit of our answer. Then we can subtract 3 tens and 5 hundreds. And that gives us 3,469 as our answer. Now let's look at 7,008, so that's 7 thousands and 8 ones, and we need to subtract 3,933. We can take away 3 of our ones to leave us with 5 as the ones digit of our answer. But then we need to subtract 3 tens. We don't have any tens, and we don't have any hundreds. So first, we need to exchange one of our thousands for 10 hundreds, so that we can take one of those hundreds and exchange it for 10 tens. Now we can take away 3 tens to leave us with 7 tens. We can take away all 9 of our hundreds, and that means we have 0 as the hundreds digit of our answer. And finally, we can take away 3 of our thousands to leave us with 3,075. That's 3 thousands, 7 tens, and 5 ones. Or with place value counters, if we start with 7,008, first, to subtract 3,933, we can subtract 3 ones to leave us with 5 ones, but then we need to subtract 3 tens. So we exchange one of our thousand counters for 10 hundreds and exchange one of our hundred counters for 10 tens. So that's why, after exchanging, we now only have 6 thousands, 9 hundreds, but that's given us 10 tens. So we can take 3 of those tens away to leave us with 7 tens. We can subtract 9 hundredths to leave us with 0 as the hundreds digit of our answer, and we can subtract 3 of our thousands to leave us with 3,075. Now let's look at 4,000 minus 2,436. To subtract 6, we first need to exchange one of our 1,000 blocks for 10 hundredths, then exchange one of our hundredths for 10 tens, and then exchange one of our tens for 10 ones. So that's why we go to the left until we get a non-zero digit. Then we can do one less, because now you can see that we only have 3,000 blocks. That gave us 1 to put in front of our hundreds digit. We had 10 hundredths, but because we exchanged, we now have 9 hundredths. That gave us 10 tens, but because we exchanged one of those tens for 10 ones, we now have 9 tens, but that's given us 1 to put in front of our ones digit, giving us 10 ones. So we can subtract 6 of those ones to leave us with 4 as the ones digit of our answer. We can subtract 3 tens to give us 6 tens. We can subtract 4 hundredths to give us 5 hundredths. And we can subtract 2 thousandths to give us 1 as the thousands digit of our answer. Or using place value counters, we start with 4,000, but first, because we're taking away 2,436, we need to subtract 6 ones. To get ones counters, first we exchange one of our thousands for 10 hundredths. We can take one of those hundredths and exchange it for 10 tens, and then take one of those tens and exchange it for 10 ones. Now we can subtract 6 ones to leave us with 4 ones. We can subtract 3 tens to give us 6 tens, 4 hundredths to give us 5 as the hundreds digit of our answer, and finally we can subtract 2 of our 1,000 counters to leave us with 1 as the thousands digit of our answer, 1,564.